great service to the Holofoid. Come find me, and I'll show you our greatest secret.
Young Lombax, I give you the Obsidian Eye, the most powerful Lorentzian telescope in the universe. It was created with lenses carved from obsidian glass and powered by a single Fulcrum star. Darkwater built it himself so as to keep in contact with his little friends.
Can it tell me where they are?
Well, sure, if we have a Fulcrum star to activate it. Here, I took the liberty of borrowing this from our archives. They're pages from Darkwater's personal journal.
Captain's log, the 3rd of August. My trip to the Brager star cluster was fraught with savings. Not only did I find a great place for cheap Krull Cobbler, but I also met a mysterious race called the Zuni. Friendly little creatures they are, can manipulate time and space to their will. Their leader gave me a Fulcrum star I can use to talk to them with once I return to Polaris. It's worth a fortune, but I wouldn't part with it for all the bolts in Meridian City. My only worry is my miserable first mate Slag. It's only a matter of moons before he tries to pillage me property. But I've taken steps to defend it well into the afterlife using an ancient Terrachnoid incantation and a coupon for one free curse at the Hulafar Magic Emporium. I'll forever bind me soul to me body so that I may protect the Fulcrum Star. He who disturbs me shall disturb my entire crew. This I swear.
Well, that star ought to be locked away with the rest of Darkwater's treasure. Find that star, and you'll find your friend.
Ratchet, I think I'm getting a signal.
Rusty Pete to Lombax, I have crucial information about Captain Darkwater. I'm dropping anchor at the Hulafar Pier. Over and out!
It's about time, mate. I've been radioing you all night. So have you found the Obsidian Eye yet?
Yeah, but it doesn't work. Darkwater hid the Fulcrum Star.
Not surprising. Cheap old Beanrake never did trust anyone. Of course, we were trying to kill him at the time. Good news is, every pirate worth their salt keeps a map to their buried treasure.
A map? Well, where is it?
Well, that's the bad news. It's probably still with his body over in Morrow Caverns. Tell you what, mate, why don't you let me help you find it? What? Can't a pirate who's never told the truth in his life go blatantly out of his way to help the Lombax who killed his best friend and captain? Great! And I have just the pirate to help us. Ta-da! I call it Slag on a Stick. Rerouted his memory banks to his vocal processor, so he'll remember anything he's looking at. Now climb aboard, mateys, and put your faith in good old Captain Slag.
There he is. Nice going. Son, can't you see I'm off the clock?
I'd be honored if you...
Hello there, fella. I thought you were meeting your friend over by the pier. Star. It's not actually a star, mind you. It's a stabilized, reusable black hole preserved in Furian crystal. It allows astronomers to peer across distances never before thought imaginable. If the Zoni were the last thing Darkwater was looking at, that star will show them. Darkwater was known for being vile, iron-fisted, and above all, cheap. It was said he pillaged a million boats without ever spending a penny. Instead, hiding his loot in a place called Darkwater Cove. Of course, no one's ever seen the island, and it's not on any map I've ever encountered. Darkwater Cove is as much a myth as this curse my constituents keep talking about. A dark place guarded by devious puzzles and booby traps. According to the legend, only Darkwater himself can pass through safely. I'm afraid I don't know much about the Zoni. Darkwater spoke of little creatures who once possessed the power to unmake existence. He referred to them as friends, but I suspect he was only biding his time. See, according to legend, the Zoni lived in a world of untold riches. Riches, I said. That's the kind of word that makes even the most rusty of pirate mouths salivate.
Change your mind about that offer? And so, our hero set forth to Morrow Caverns in search of a map to the mythical Fulcrum Star. With him was Rusty Pete, a noble and true corsair, adored by women across the galaxy.
This be a work of fiction.
Do you even know where we're going?
Of course I do! I got GPS. Look!
Turn right at Isle of Despair. In 5 leagues, keep left.
I love this thing. Hanukkah gift from me mom, it was.
Arriving at destination on right.
Here we are, Morrow Caverns. Famous for its majestic fjords, soothing grottos, and legions of tortured souls awaiting their chance for revenge.
What?
What? I didn't say nothing.
I still don't understand why we need Slag to find Darkwater. Didn't you help him hide the ship?
Well, I was a bit soft at the time. Woke up 3 days later wearing an evening gown and spooning a kerchief. Watch your tails! Get the dog, would you, mate?
Ratchet, I'll try to find a way out of here. Just promise we'll leave this place together, okay? Thanks, Ratchet.
This path is so dangerous, so forbidden, that only a recitation of the fabled Song of the Dead shall open the way.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is me handle, here is me spout.
Shimmy across. I'd do it myself if I hadn't suffered an unfortunate jig dancing injury.
No dangerous wildlife in these caverns.